haven't done in a long time, and that's get to double digits in win. Currently right now, they are 4-4 in conference play, right around fifth place behind Prairie View A&M and University. With a win tonight, they could secure a fourth place spot going in to the second half of the season. Meanwhile, Mississippi Valley State University is coming off of a huge win on the road against Texas Southern University in overtime. Will they be able to take the same momentum into this game against Grambling State University? It's Grambling basketball against Mississippi Valley State University, live from here at the Fergusy Hobby Assembly Center. We'll have all the action starting right up for you in just a minute, right here on GSU TV. Are they ready to go on at the buzzer?
One game between the your Grambling State University Tigers and the Mississippi Valley Devils. Here's the president, Richard J. Gallo, and director of athletics, Paul Ebrock, would like to welcome all online fans of Grambling and hope that you enjoy the game. And now, let's get our starting lineup to begin first with the Devils from Mississippi Valley. At guard, number one, Marcus Roman. At forward, at number two, Ronald Schroeder. At forward, at number 22, Michael Medlock. At guard, at number 24, Isaac Williams. And at forward, at number 33, Jamal Watson.
Welcome back to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University. It's time once again for GSU basketball. This game is very important for both of these teams. It is virtually the end of the first half of the season. Mississippi Valley State University. The Tigers lead this win 5-4 in conference play and start the second half of the season. Be extremely challenging. The second half of the season for the Tigers will start at Southern University this Saturday. Next Monday, they will play against Alcorn State University. Then, of course, coming up the following week, they will be at home against Texas Southern and Prairie View, and then they will have a three-game stretch on the road that will feature Jackson, Arkansas, Pine Bluff, and, of course, Mississippi Valley State University. So, big games coming up for this Grambling State University Tiger football team. And, of course, one of the things that they want to do is they want to make sure that they put themselves in position to make sure that they are in good shape for the second half of the season. All right, let's tell you a little bit about what's going on. Conference records for the Grambling, for all of these teams. We'll get to those in just a little bit. We'll tell you a little bit about where these teams are in the Southwestern Athletic Conference so far. As far as wins and losses, this Mississippi Valley State Delta Devil team is 3-5 in conference play, but very, very aggressive as far as the what they've been doing this year. All right, let's talk about the starting lineups here. First of all, for the Delta Devils, Marcus Romaine. He is one of the big-time players for this Mississippi Valley State Delta Devil basketball team. He's averaging 16.5 points a game, as well as 3.7 rebounds. And then, of course, you've got Ronald Struther, a 6'6 sophomore from Hueytown, Alabama. Michael Matlock, a 6'7 senior from Memphis, Tennessee. And Isaac Williams, another big piece of this puzzle for the Delta Devils, 13 points a ball game. He's also averaging just over 3 rebounds a ball game in Jamal Watson. For the Grambling Tigers, Irvin Mitchell, Nigel Ribeiro, Raymond Brown, Chase Cormier, and Avril Ugbe. Ugbe will be jumping at center with Jamal Watson. The Tigers have the basketball, and Nigel Ribeiro will control. It's an exciting basketball this past Saturday night. We'll tell you about that in a minute. Three-pointer by Irvin Mitchell to start things off. And it's 3-0, Tigers on top. Tigers right away want to make sure that they establish the tempo of this ball game. Delta Devils with the basketball. Made a little change. Marcus Romaine coming out. Nigel Ribeiro coming in after the miss. Irvin Mitchell, another three. No good. And the rebound by Marcus Romaine. Romaine coming down the floor quickly for the Delta Devils. Three-pointer now by Isaac Williams. He's the other threat for this Delta Devil ball club. And now Raymond Brown with the basketball. Brown going in. Going for the shot, no good. Blocking foul coming up on Mississippi Valley. 3-0 is our score. That foul is on Isaac Williams, first personal, and the first team on the Delta Devils. At the line for the Grambling Tigers, the 6'4 senior from Monroe, Louisiana, Raymond Brown, went to Richwood High School. First free throw is up and good. One more free throw opportunity. The Delta Devils recruiting heavily in the Milwaukee, Wisconsin area near my hometown. Second free throw is up and good. Daryl Riley coming from North Division High School and Javon Smith coming from Milwaukee Lutheran. That's a North Division High School very well known for basketball along with Milwaukee, Washington, and Bayview. Marcus Romaine with the basketball. Hands it off inside. That's going to be Jamal Watson. Shot up and good, and it's now 5-2. Grambling on top. Cormier crossed the half-court line, and it was a great pass inside as you're watching live on GSU TV inside. Great basket. And on the other side, Nigel Ribeiro with a three-pointer in and out. No good. Jamal Watson with the rebound. And coming down the floor, Marcus Romaine. Three-pointer by Ronald Struther. And the putback is good. 5-4 now the score, 18-21 remaining here in this first half. And let's watch the replay here on GSU TV. You can see the putback there by Jamal Watson. Really doing a great job cleaning up. Irvin Mitchell now to Nigel Ribeiro. Ribeiro coming towards the circles. Now to Irvin Mitchell. Three-pointer on the way, no good. And right there with the rebound, Raymond Brown, and they're going to call a foul on the floor as there was good positioning. That foul is going to go against 33, Jamal Watson. And when you see the Tigers moving the ball around after that shot Urban Mitchell took, and Raymond Brown doing a great job of getting position on the inside, drawing that foul. Mitchell now with the basketball, tightly guarded by Romaine. Nice ball movement here by the Tigers early on. Valley defending the inside, not allowing Avril Ugbe to get anything. Now to Irvin Mitchell, 13 left on the shot clock. Shot is up and good. Irv Mitchell now with 5 points here in the ball game, and it's now 7-4. Bramlett on top. 17-33 remaining here in this first half of play. Isaac Williams controlling. Out of Romaine. Nice defense by the Grambling. Tigers a near steal inside. Ball is on the floor, and Raymond Brown finally coming away with it. Brown gets it out to Ribeiro. Out of Cormier. Gets it to Raymond Brown. Brown with the shot up, no good. No follow on that. And one of the things that Coach Walker is telling them about is make sure they follow their shot. One-on-one, tightly played with Romaine. Inside shot, no good. There's Raymond Brown, a home run pass. Now to Chase Cormier, goes in, easy deuce. Great defense by the Tigers. Tigers showing a little bit of press here. And now, Irv Mitchell coming up to help a little bit. Man-to-man press setup. Now a little bit of zone pressure here by the Grambling Tigers. 10-second violation charged to Mississippi Valley. And it will go back to the Grambling Tigers. Great defense by the Grambling Tigers early on as they force a 10-second violation. So now Irv Mitchell will get the ball inbounded. 9-4 is our score. The Grambling Tigers on top, 16.5 remaining here in the first half of action. Raymond Brown, spin move inside, goes in and gets it blocked. Ugbe right there with the rebound and the putback. And that's something the Tigers will have to do is establish the boards if they're going to beat Mississippi Valley. That's one of the things that they did against Texas Southern University. They really did a great job offensively in getting offensive rebounds. Irv Mitchell, nice double team. The ball is thrown. It's going to be out of bounds off of Valley and back to Grambling. Now coming into the Delta Devil lineup will be number 11. That's going to be Kylie Phillips, the son from Memphis. They also have Daryl Riley from Milwaukee. And Tajay Henry, the 6'5 senior from Queens, New York, transferred from Southeastern Community College. Mitchell with the basketball. Now looking inside. It's going to be a foul away from the basketball. And that foul is going to be charged, I believe. It's going to be charged to Raymond Brown. That'll be his first personal and the team's first. We have a media timeout on the floor with the score. Grambling Tigers 11 and Mississippi Valley 4. We'll take this timeout. You're watching Grambling Basketball Live on GSU TV. Live action here at the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center. Let's send it over to Taylor for a sideline report.
just about 5 or so minutes into the game, and your GSU Tigers are leading 11-4. You know, the Tigers are currently standing in fifth place, and a win tonight could push them up to fourth, beating in front of Prairie View A&M. However, Valley just upset Texas Southern last week, so this is definitely going to be one of those games that the Tigers have got to make sure that every point counts. Back to you, Santoria.
All right, thanks a lot, Taylor. Back to live action. Foul on the floor, and that's going to be charged to Averill Ube. And that will be his first personal, the second team, but it is a shooting foul. Talking about what happened this past Saturday, I was at that Southern game against Alcorn, and that game wasn't even close. 74-64, Reginald Johnson, big foul, 20 points in that ball game. Grambling A&M beat Alabama A&M. That was a tightly fought ball game, 70-65. Grambling beat Pine Bluff, 61-53. It was Jackson over Mississippi Valley, 83-68. And Texas Southern, boy, they barely got by Alabama State, 70-68. That's the second close ball game that they've had in a row. And Valley with the steal, and that was number 10, Tajay Henry, and he gets the bucket. And it's now 11-8, so four quick points here by Mississippi Valley. Ball goes out of bounds off of Grambling and back to Mississippi Valley. And now the Delta Devils feeling a little bit of mojo, I guess you could say, a little bit of momentum change. 15-12 first half of the way. 11-8, Grambling on top. It was an 11-4 ball game, and Valley scored 4 points. Couple of free throws, and then, of course, Tajay Henry with a bucket. Daryl Riley with the basketball. Coach Andre Payne making a little bit of a change after a slow start, and easy floating jumper there by Daryl Riley, and the senior from Milwaukee now has a couple. Great job by Daryl Riley going in, putting a little spin move on Irv Mitchell for the floating jumper. Here's a shot by Drake Wilkes, three-pointer on the way, no good, and the Valley 6-0 run right now for the Delta Devils. And a wild shot put up. And here comes Grambling Tigers. Nigel Ribeiro getting it to Irv Mitchell. Back to Ribeiro, wide open three-pointer, and he doesn't hit anything. And we have a substitution. Chase Cormier coming in, giving Nigel Ribeiro a little bit of a breather. Just seems like he got a little case of the yips. 11-10 our score, 14:05 remaining, first half of play. Riley with the basketball for the Delta Devils. Gets it to Kylan Phillips. Phillips drives back to Riley. Riley with a three-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound by Henry. Henry goes back up for the shot, no good. Ball tipped around, goes off of Valley and back to the Grambling Tigers. 13:40 remaining first half action, 14-10 our score. Raymond Brown will inbound, substitution in the lineup, and that's Jabari Alex, the 6'4 senior from Proviso East High School in Chicago, Illinois. They've been to the state quarters a couple of times during his time at Proviso East in the state of Illinois. Shot up, no good. Going to be an offensive foul charge. That's an easy call. Offensive foul charge, and that's going to be the first foul on Chase Cormier. 13:31 remaining, first half action. 11-10 our score. Delta Devils will now come from the other side of the floor. Grambling Tigers 4-4 in conference play. Actually behind Prairie View and ahead of Jackson. They're behind Prairie View because Prairie View beat them in the first half of the season, but still in first place, in fifth place. Four teams are 4-4 coming into this evening's action. Here's a shot by Alex. It's up, no good, and it goes out of bounds off of Grambling and back to the Delta Devils. 1 second remaining on the shot clock. 1 second. defend here. Rondell Hunt. And an easy putback almost there for Tajay Henry. And Coach Walker not happy about that because that was a miss. Chase Cormier now with the basketball coming back towards the G. Now Irv Mitchell. Irv Mitchell defended by Phillips. Raymond Brown nearly lost the ball. Brown goes up for the shot. Offensive foul charged to Raymond Brown. And for Brown, that'll be his second personal. So with 12:34 remaining in the first half of play, it's 11-10 our score, and Raymond Brown already has his second personal foul. Now Nigel Ribeiro will come back into the lineup. And Mississippi Valley will have the basketball. Now left side. Left on the shot clock for the Delta Devils. Riley, top of the key. Lorenzo Hunt, 6'4 freshman from Memphis, gets the ball back to Riley. Three-pointer on the way, good. First three-pointer of the contest for the Delta Devils, and they now have a 13-11 lead. And I had the chance to talk to Lee Hall, and he said this team, as you're looking at Daryl Riley shooting that three, it has been very inconsistent. Shot up and good by Drake Wilkes. 13 all now between these two teams. 11:43 remaining in this first half of action. As Wilkes stepping inside the three-point line and getting the big jumper. Valley with the basketball. Tajay Henry will drive, getting inside the paint. No good. Ball tipped and recovered by Drake Wilkes. Johnny on the spot. Now to Cormier. Cormier getting it to Raymond Brown. And now over to Irv Mitchell. He goes in for the bucket. Great job by the offense moving the ball around and ended up getting back, taking advantage of Valley. They fell asleep on the backside, and Irv Mitchell was able to get an easy shot inside the lane. Jabari Alex now with the basketball, getting it to Tajay Henry. Now to Lorenzo Hunt. Shot up by Hunt. No good. Rebound by Ube to Irv Mitchell. Delta Devils before the ball game. Saw the ball move. That's going to be a foul. A blocking foul. And it looks like it's going to be on Lorenzo Hunt. As you see, Raymond Brown getting it to Irv Mitchell, drawing the foul, and after the media timeout, we will have a couple of free throws as Coach Andre Payne really upset with Jabari Alex. We'll take this timeout. You're watching Grambling State University basketball on GSU TV. Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. The Tigers on top of Valley, 15-13. Let's go over to Taylor with this sideline report.
About 10 minutes into the game or so, and your Tigers are leading 15-13. There's a lot of ball movement going on the court, a lot of aggression. However, again, the Tigers have to remember that every point counts. So execution is going to be the big thing tonight. Back to you, Santoria.
All right, thanks a lot, Taylor. And, of course, as we were saying that, Irv Mitchell, every point counts. He misses the first free throw. The Tigers right now, that was the first free throw that they missed tonight. Raymond Brown was 2-for-2. Irv Mitchell, 0-for-2. And Coach Walker, not happy. That's one of the staples that he said that is so important for this team in order to win, is hitting the free throws. Irv Mitchell missed those bad. Three-pointer on the way up and no good. Rebounded the putback by number 23, Amos Given. And Coach Walker calls a 30-second timeout. He'll make a substitution, and here's why. There's a little move right here. This basket was no good, but right there on the putback was Amos Given, and Coach Walker furious on the sideline because he does not want Mississippi Valley to get easy buckets. One of his coaches had their scowls on their face really early in the ballgame. Right there behind Andre Payne, just to his left. Long-time assistant basketball coach, Eric Struthers. He's had an illustrious career as an assistant coach. I'm telling you, he is going to get his shot as a head coach at some point. Been an assistant coach under Andy Stoglin at Jackson State University, and of course also did some assistant coaching at the Division II level. And tell you what, that is a young coach that is definitely going to get his chance at some point in time. Been around the SWAC more than 20 years. And a steal by Mississippi Valley. That's going to be a blocking foul charge to the Grambling Tigers. Isaac Williams will go to the free throw line. Chase Cormier picking up his second foul, and here you see Cormier just with a little bit of a careless pass, and you could see that Isaac Williams was kind of telegraphing that pass, kind of lying in wait, second personal by Cormier. So Brown and Cormier both with two fouls. First free throw up, good. Coming into the ball game now for the Grambling Tigers, Ivy Smith, junior freshman from Seattle, Washington. And he's a guy that has given some good minutes here to the Tigers. Coach Walker said that Smith, really good player, and he's going to be good for this team, but one of the problems that he has at times is that he kind of stays in the doghouse from time to time. Nigel Rivera with the basketball. Gets it out to Ivy Smith Jr. Three-pointer by Drake Wilkes. No good. And the rebound by Mississippi Valley. In the ball game for Grambling, Deontay Jones as well. Rebound to put back there by Isaac Williams, I should say Amos Given, no good. Here comes Nigel Rivera. Rivera giving a little fake. And the ball goes out of bounds off of Valley and back to Grambling. Now Avril Ugbe coming into the contest. I don't know, it seems like to me that he should have just went in for the bucket there instead of dishing it off. As you see, a great steal here by Nigel Rivera, and he had it looks like he had the fake, but Deontay Jones just couldn't hang on to the basketball. Ivy Smith Jr. now to Rivera. 23 on the foul, that's Amos Given, 6'4" junior from Shreveport, went to Southern University Shreveport for 2 years before transferring to Mississippi Valley. Now in the land of the Delta Devils. Grambling Tigers now with the basketball, 9:30 remaining here in this first half of play, 16-15 the Valley. Ugbe with the shot, it's up, it's no good, and nice job by Wilkes tying the basketball up. And unfortunately the possession arrow goes back to Valley, but Drake Wilkes right there to not give a free rebound. You can see the shot going up. Three Delta Devils around, and Wilkes just being aggressive and going after the basketball. Got to get more white shirts around the basketball on the rebounding edge. At that last minute timeout, 10-8 in favor of Grambling on the rebound. With the ball now for the Delta Devils is given foul cut. It's going to be a travel. And it will go back to the Grambling Tigers. Right. 16-15 is the score. Grambling trailing by one. Nigel Ribeiro nearly had his pocket picked again. Now he gets it to Ivy Smith Jr. Utah Valley. Oh, nice job by Ivy Smith Jr. Goes up for the bucket. And Smith really igniting this crowd, putting on a little bit of a show. Smith Jr. did that against Arkansas Pine Bluff and against Jackson. Look at the crossover dribble right there on Daryl Riley. And that's why Coach Walker likes him so much. And Ivy Smith Jr. with the first free throw. And Andre Payne giving it to his young guard as he comes over to the bench. Disappointed in the way that he just handled that. Got shook right out of his boots. Steal. with the basketball. Over to Darryl Riley, three-pointer up, no good. And that's going to be a foul coming up against Ube. And I think that's two on Ube. And so now you've got three players in foul trouble with 8:34 remaining here in the first half of play. Raymond Brown, Chase Cormier, and Avril Ube all have two personals. And so now after this free throw, first free throw up and no good. That's Tajay Henry, the senior from Queens, New York. Henry shooting 56% coming into tonight's ball game, and he misses two. Drake Wilkes with the rebound for the Grambling Tigers. Travel violation, and the Tigers give the ball right back to Mississippi Valley. Now in the ball game for Mississippi Valley, looks like Isaac Williams coming back into the lineup. Also, Vaca Vaughn. That is a basketball name. And Vaca Vaughn gets his first basket of the contest, the 6-4 senior from Memphis. And here's Ivy Smith Jr. Oh, Smith turned the ball over, and picking it off is Isaac Williams down the floor. Romaine saved it. Now Nigel Rivera with the basketball. He's fouled. And at that media timeout, I'm sure that the Tigers are trying to settle some things down. Nigel Rivera will get it into Ami Smith Jr. Smith trying to shake Romaine a little bit. Gets it to Nigel Rivera. Oh, it's going to be a travel. It was a nice thought there by Ivy Smith. Took the went to the left, came back to the right, but took a step there. And you can see Ivy Smith coming over, getting the ball back from Nigel Rivera. Just that little move right there on the travel. We'll take this timeout here. 18-17, the score. Valley on top of Grambling with 7:48 left in the first half. We'll take this time out. You're watching GSU TV. No sideline report after this time out. All right. Back here on GSU TV, the Delta Devils on top of Grambling 18-17 with 7:43 remaining here in this first half of action. Delta Devils really moving the ball around the perimeter well. Vaca Vaughn now with the ball. That's a hard basketball name to forget. Nearly a foul by Ivy Smith Jr. 6 seconds left on the play clock. Three-pointer on the way. It's no good. And a foul on the floor. Let's see who the foul's going to be on. Looks like that foul is going to be on number 40, Noah Cummings. He's 6'9", senior from Pembroke, North Carolina. Picks up his first. Couple of throws here by Tajay Henry. Free throws in the ball game, 3-for-6 for Valley. And make that 3-for-7. Ball goes out of bounds off of Valley, and it'll come back to, no, off of Grambling, it'll come back to Valley. But careless ball handling by some of the guards in this ball game. Careless ball handling. Now coming into the contest for the Delta Devils, number 33, Jerome Watson from Long Beach, California. Cerritos College transfer. And a steal by Nigel Ribeiro. Ribeiro, I'm going to call an offensive foul on that play. There's no way that that's an offensive foul. A little bit of acting going on by one of the Delta Devil players, and the official bit right into it. Ribeiro, you see, gets the steal. Comes across the line, gets it to Marcus Romaine. And Romaine just, that's a flop. That's a clear flop. When you look at that again, Nigel Ribeiro, I mean, that's not even a push. That's a flop. 18-17 the score. Grambling trailing with 6:55 remaining here in this first half of play. Marcus Romaine with the basketball, gets it left side to Riley. Riley now to Williams. Williams shot from the right elbow, good. Now the Delta Devils, largest lead of the ball game, 3 points, 20-17. Ball goes out of bounds off of Valley, back to the Grambling State University Tigers. In the ball game for Grambling is Marcel Thompson, the freshman from Baltimore. Also in the ball game, Zarius Larry, the junior from Farmerville, transfer from Southern University Junior College.
Don't do it, Darryl.
Wilkes now with the basketball. They're going to call a foul on Grambling. And Coach Walker saying there's no way that that's a foul. There's no way that that's a foul. Wilkes gets it over. What are they looking at? They call a turnover there, actually. They call a travel. Not sure what they were calling there. Coach Walker upset about the call. Shot just inside the three-point line, up no good. Wilkes with the rebound for the Grambling Tigers. Zarius Larry, it's going to be a blocking foul. Very physical ball game with these two teams. As you can see, Zarius Larry doing a great job with the penetration, crossover dribble, and did a great job of drawing the foul. Free throw coming up here for the Grambling Tigers. They're, I believe, 3-4-6 at the line. Make that 4-7. Got to start hitting free throws. They've missed three and they're down three. 5:42 left in this first half of play. Isaac Williams gets the ball out to Romaine. Romaine turns around with the shot, no good. They're going to call a foul on Valley and it'll go back to Grambling. So a fake inside. And that's going to be charged to Marcus Romaine. That'll be his first personal. And so now Coach Ave Payne not happy about the call. Irv Mitchell at the free throw line for the Grambling Tigers. Gets that free throw. Tigers now 5 of 8 at the charity stripe. Irv Mitchell, one of the better free throw shooters. Hits this one, 6 for 9 now. That's 66%. That's what the team is shooting as a team, 66%. Back 20-19, our score. A steal here by Irv Mitchell. Up to Zarius Larry. Mitchell loses it. and they're going to call it out of bounds off of Grambling back to the Delta Devils. Irv Mitchell was trying to go up hard, lost control of it. I'm not sure if he got fouled. Zarius Larry, I'm not sure what he did. .514 remaining in the first half of action. 2-3 zone set up by the Grambling Tigers. Three-pointer on the way. Wow, nothing but net. That's 24, Isaac Williams, who's now 1-for-2 from the field and has 6 points. Make that 8 points. 23-19 to score, 4:48 remaining in the first half. Zarius Larry for three. It's up. It's no good. No white shirts are around for rebound. They got to crash the boards if they're going to win this ball game. Three-pointer on the way. Good from Isaac. Once again, Isaac Williams, two consecutive three-pointers. Now the largest lead of the game for the Delta Devils at 26-19. Zarius Larry now with the basketball. Three-pointer on the way. Good. That's number 22. Carlton Lowe, the senior. His first three-pointer of the ballgame. First points of the ballgame. 26-22. Now under four remaining in the first half of play. Chase Cormier getting ready to come in. And there's no five-second call there. Shot up, no good. The rebound and the putback is good. And we have a timeout on the floor. We have a timeout on the floor with the score. The Grambling Tigers trailing 28-22. 3:45 remaining in this first half of action. We'll take this timeout. You're listening and you're watching Grambling Basketball on GSU TV. Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. The Delta Devils in town tonight. They lead Grambling 28-22. Let's go to the sideline now for this report.
The Tigers are trailing the Mississippi Devils 28-22. You know, like we said before, every shot counts. We can't miss any more free throws, any more threes. We have to make sure that when we shoot to score at this point in the game. Back to you, Santoria.
All right, that's Chase Cormier now with the basketball to Drake Wilkes. Wilkes now looking right side, gets it to Carlton Lowe, who's got a three-pointer. Lowe nearly got the ball stolen. Irv Mitchell gets it back. Now Grambling has some numbers. Mitchell goes in, can't hit the shot, gets his own rebound, though. He goes in and gets the bucket. 28-24, 3:12 remaining here in the first half of play.
Hey, make up for it, buddy. Make up for it, buddy.
And it's going to be a foul. That's a good call by the official. Looks like that's going to be charged to number 24, Deontay Jones, first personal. And the Delta Devils are in the double bonus, it looks like. Grambling 6-for-9 at the charity stripe, 7-for-19 from the field. Valley 11-for-30, first free throw up, no good. The Delta Devils keeping Grambling in the ball game because they're shooting less than 50% from the free throw line. 3-for-8 now. Grambling being out rebounded, 19-18. But the big category that I'm sure that Coach Walker will talk about at halftime, 12 turnovers in the first half. Chase Cormier with the basketball, gets it out to Deontay Jones. Jones gives him for the bucket, no good. Rebound by Carlton Lowe, and he has it stripped from him. Nice block by Deontay Jones. Irv Mitchell with the basketball, out to Chase Cormier. To Carlton Lowe, he goes up for the shot, and it's blocked. He draws a foul. That foul's going to be on 24, I believe, and great job by Irv Mitchell starting the break after that block by Jones. And going in, drawing the foul is 22, Carlton Lowe. Lowe, a 6'2 senior from Alexandria, Louisiana. First free throw is good. And you can see this once again. I want to show you something on this replay. You look at Chase Cormier, where his eyes are. Nice bounce pass right there on the baseline. Carlton Lowe had great positioning, and he was going to draw the contact. Free throw up and no good. 7-4-11 for the Grambling Tigers. Valley moving on defense with the trying to overload one side of the zone here on the 2-3. Ocean offense because of the man-to-man defense set up by Valley. Drake Wilkes controls the basketball, and he's defended by Marcus Romaine. And a foul coming up out high. Charge to Tajay Henry. It's going to be his first personal. And Wilkes did a great job just saving the basketball. And then, of course, bringing it back towards the middle of the floor. And Tajay Henry being a little bit aggressive on Irv Mitchell trying to play the passing lane. And Mitchell goes to the free throw line. First free throw by Irv Mitchell is good. Shooting 68% coming into tonight's basketball game. Vaca Vaughn now coming back into the contest. Two for two on the trip. 9-for-13 now for the Tigers, and it's now 29-27, and that is why Grambling has stayed in this basketball game. Daryl Riley controlling. Struther, not a Riley, defended by Cormier. 10 on the shot clock. Near steal there by Irv Mitchell. Marcus Romaine, little bit of a bump, little push. Three-pointer on the way as time expires on the shot clock, no good. Mitchell out to Chase Cormier. Cormier, nice job to Drake Wilkes. Three-pointer, good! Drake Wilkes dialing up from long distance, and it's 30-29. Tigers take the lead with under a minute to go. Nice job by Carlton Lowe on the switch there with Chase Cormier on defense. Oh, that looked like a double dribble. And the official right there on that one. Good switch. Inside, Vaca Vaughn with the bucket with 28 seconds left. They gave up an easy one on the inside to Vaca Vaughn on the backside. Now Chase Cormier. 31-30, Valley on top. And now Irv Mitchell with the basketball. Mitchell goes up for the shot, no good. Ball tipped. And it comes down to Valley. Foul on Carlton Lowe. 31-30, 6.4 left. That's a bad foul because you put Valley on the line with 6 seconds remaining in the ball in the first half. First free throw is up. Good. 32-30. Coming into the ball game now is Jamal Watson, mainly for defense. Grambling getting back now. Raymond Brown now coming into the ball game. Now Mississippi Valley dropping back on defense with 6.4 left. Chase Cormier with the basketball, moving quickly down the floor. Chase Cormier, coast to coast, misses the bucket as time expires in the first half. Well, he had the shot, just couldn't cash in. And we're at 33-30 as we go into the halftime locker room. We'll take this time out. As you see, Chase Cormier did everything right, split the defense, went in, just could not get it off the glass. We'll take this time out. When we come back, we'll have an interview with the Dean of Students and the Vice President of Student Affairs, Dr. David Ponton. That's coming up next right here on GSU TV. We'll be right back. All right, Coach. Take care, man. to the Frederick C. Hamdi Center on the campus of Grambling State University. Santoria Black joined by the interim vice president of student affairs, Dr. David Rusty Ponton. And I know you as Coach Pete.
Always Coach Pete, sir.
Well, I tell you what, let's talk a little bit about some of the great things going on. You know, there's been a rejuvenated spirit on this campus.
It has. I mean, President Gallo has come in and he's shown us that, hey, he's going to be here for a while. He's dedicated. He's given us everything that he can give us right now. So what we're trying to do is make sure we give him everything we can give him. I mean, from student affairs to the academic areas, everything. I mean, the athletic teams are doing great. The spirit around campus is just good right now. I mean, people are coming back. People are giving. We got a real nice crowd for a Monday night here tonight.
Oh, absolutely.
So it's like old Grambling is coming back, baby.
Absolutely. And, you know, one of the things that there was oftentimes criticism about is the consistency of administration on campus. With President Gallo coming in, showing he's going to be here long term, and then of course hiring Paul Bryant as the athletic director, and it's not just one of those one and done kind of contracts, where there's a contract that shows some longevity there. It really starts to show the alumni and givers that now all of a sudden Grambling is more serious about long term administration.
And that's crucial. I mean, who do you give your money to? You're going to give your money to those individuals who are going to be around for a while. And I think the trust level, President Gallo has the trust of those individuals who are around. I think athletic director, he's going to come in now and he's going to be able to set some things up. All of them set some things up that I think that we haven't seen for a while. So it'll be sustained leadership.
One of the things that's really interesting about the spirit here on campus is that, of course, the football team winning the HBCU National Championship, the SLAC Championship. I mean, they just have done a tremendous job. And one thing that I tell people all the time is athletics is the window to the university. And also, you can always see an uptick in registration and attendance when you see football winning.
Yes. Actually, we have a big piece of enrollment this semester. Our admissions department, enrollment management department, are doing a phenomenal job. And we're up 250 students at this point last year in the spring semester. So all of those things are just positive indicators. We're really growing. I think our students are getting rejuvenated. Our applications are up past last year. So it's just a great time to be at Grambling State University.
Absolutely. What are some things coming up from your office, from student affairs, that you can tell our fans and tell our listeners and viewers about?
Well, you know, we just finished with a welcome week. Our student activities there, they do a phenomenal job. Kids had a great time. They did tie-dyes. They had little things around camp. So get the kids kind of keep them motivated at the beginning of the semester. Well, we have coming up, we're going to have two things in the
You know, I heard something the other day and you thought that there would be a little bit of disagreement, but the understanding was the Tuesday events that they had on the yard, the Turn Up Tuesdays, President decided, let's not do that right now and let's get back to classroom. And most of the students were like, you know what, we need to stay in class.
Right, and a lot of things that we want people to understand is that those Turn Up Tuesdays were not done by the community. There's different groups because that was a time that was a lot of time because there were no classes during those times.
That's right.
And now we have classes during those times, so there's no real need to fill in those activities. Like most of those activities are in the evening.
I tell you what, Coach B, just an exciting time here at Grambling State University. We even see the basketball teams doing extremely well now. And, you know, I looked at some of the standings and when I was doing the Alcorn and Southern game the other night for television, and you see Grambling climbing up the stats on the men's side. You see some of that old magic coming back from Lady Tigers.
I tell you what,
really good.
I miss it. I'm out here on the sideline, so I'm just coaching.
I'm telling you.
It's kind of funny to have these headsets on with you again like that. Back in the day, but I think the coaches are doing a phenomenal job.
Yeah.
Our kids are responding, and they're coming out, they're playing hard. And when we play hard, I think they realize we can play with anybody in the conference.
Yeah.
You know, so we just got to win all of our home stretches, go out and at least split on the road, and we're going to be okay. We've been in that tournament, anybody can win.
And it's going to be tough. Southern and Alcorn coming up next, and you know all too well what it's like going down to Southern University and then to Alcorn playing at Saturday-Monday swing. Very difficult. And the ladies of Alcorn played very well, beat Southern the other night.
Yes, that's when you know the parity is great in the conference right now. It's going to be a tough stretch for us. We have to at least split on that road.
Yeah.
I think we can win both of them. I think when we go in there and play like we're capable of playing, both men and women can win both of those games.
Absolutely. Coach P, always a pleasure.
Always a pleasure, sir. Thanks a lot. Go Tigers.
Coach P joining us. Of course, Dr. David Rusty Palantown. We know him as Coach P.
Always Coach P. Always Coach P. Coaches are more revered in love. The doctors, lawyers, judges. Coaches are always revered in love.
Oh, absolutely. We'll take this time out. When we come back, we'll have second half action right here on GSU TV.
Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.
Welcome back here to the second half of action between the Grambling Tigers and Mississippi Valley State University. Taking a look at some of the numbers, the Delta Devils led in scoring by Isaac Williams with 11 points. He's 2-for-3 from long distance and 3-for-4 in free throws. For the Grambling Tigers, they led by Irvin Mitchell, 13 points. Avery Ube has 4 rebounds on the evening, but the big thing, 2 personal fouls early on by Noah Cummings, Chase Cormier, Avery Ube, and Raymond Brown all had 2 personal fouls in that first half. And Raymond Brown got them very early and had to come out of the ball game. 12-6 on second chance points or points off turnover, and 14-6 in the paint in favor of Mississippi Valley. Grambling with the basketball to start the second half. Chase Cormier trying to get it inside, force it to Raymond Brown, but he gets the turnover.
Shoot it, little baby.
Goes in and gets the bucket. Nice job by Raymond Brown, kind of just going straight up in the air. And now it's 33-32. This is going to be a close game, a little bit of a bad matchup problem between these two teams. Tigers now on defense. Riley thought about the three-pointer, didn't, and a three-pointer there by Marcus Romaine, and it's now 36-32. Grambling trailing. A nice job by Marcus Romaine. Raymond Brown couldn't get it to Irv Mitchell. It goes out of bounds. And Coach Sean Walker is furious. ...36-32, 18:53 remaining here in the ball game. Valley running their offense. Shot up and good. Tajay Henry, can't do too much about that. That was just great penetration by Henry. Chase Cormier with the basketball. Inside to Avery Ube. Ube to Chase Cormier. Cormier goes up for the shot. Can't hit the bucket. Rebound by Isaac Williams. And Tajay Henry going in for the bucket. 18:06 remaining. And boy, I tell you the truth, Valley doing a great job in transition. And Tajay Henry going in for the bucket. Wise decision not to foul. 8-point deficit now for the Grambling Tigers. Valley with the basketball, and it's tipped by Brown, couldn't get it. And a shot up and good by Marcus Romaine. And now, largest lead of the ball game for the Delta Devils, 42-32. Full court pressure, 2-2-1 on the pressure. Ube goes in, gets the bucket, and draws the foul. Ugba with the foul, and of course a great job by Raymond Brown to come down. And then of course we saw Nigel Ribeiro get it off to Ugba. Free throw is up and good. Well, he needed that free throw there. 42-35, cuts it to 7. 3-point play the hard way. Nice job by Brown cutting off the dribble. And now to Nigel Ribeiro on the turnover. Ribeiro. Oh, it's going to be a push-off. No, they're going to say that it's going to be a foul on Valley. You can see that Nigel Ribeiro did a great job stepping in front of the pass on the transition. I thought it was going to be a push-off at first. Colin Phillips with the foul. First personal. 42-35 now the score coming into the ball game for the Delta Devils. Lorenzo Hunt. I think just about everybody except Rashawn Searles has played in this ball game. Like everybody else has played. Valley with the turnover here. And with the bucket, Daryl Riley, the senior from Milwaukee. Boy, their head coach Andre Payne, he's really into it. cowboy boots and all. Wilkes inside foul. It's going to be coming up on Colin Phillips. I believe that'd be a second personal. Nigel Ribeiro doing a great job giving it to Wilkes. There's a shot there. Avril Lugby with the shot, and it's now 44-37. remaining here. Coach Walker telling everybody to stay in front of the ball. Ugbe knocking the ball out of bounds. 27 left on the play clock. Well, I tell you what, Coach Andre Payne over there for Mississippi Valley wearing that floor out on the visitor sideline with those cowboy boots. He has been excited the entire game. And now the official telling Marcus Romain to keep his spot and Ugbe to keep the legal distance. Don't step over that line. And the Delta Devils able to get the ball across half court, and then the ball is tipped out of the hands of number 11, Colin Phillips, and here comes Grambling to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell will take it himself, go in for the shot, no good, and the ball is tipped. Nice job by Drake Wilkes as he'll go to the free throw line. Foul coming up against the Delta Devils. Irv Mitchell was taking it coast to coast, a little bit hard off the glass, but great job there by Wilkes. Foul, and then of course Grambling gets the ball back. Ugbe goes in for the shot. Good! Ugba with the basket. Oh, they call a technical foul on Ugba. Well, they call a technical foul on Ugba, and we're going to show you why. Here on the inbound pass, right there, we'll show you here, they tipped the ball out of his hands while he was out of bounds. That's a technical foul, and Valley will shoot two at the line. That's why the technical foul happened. You cannot hit the ball out of the inbounder's hands. That is a technical foul. 44-39, so unfortunately, a couple steps forward and a couple steps back here for the Grambling Tigers. Now 45-39, and the Delta Devils will get the ball back. Ugbe cannot swing at the line, and now just playing good defense. And Wilkes stepping right in front of the ball, and a turnover there by Valley. Here's Irv Mitchell, he can't control it, and the ball comes back down to Valley. They get the turnover that they wanted. Shot up, no good. Nice job by Wilkes on the block. Here comes Ribeiro. No quit for the Tigers, he's fouled. Safe, going right into the cameraman. And they got to check on Ribeiro there. He took a nasty slide. Coach Cooper would have been proud of that on the baseball team. Here's Ribeiro coming across the half-court line, and he goes in, and boy, he is just tripped and heads right into the camera line. Is he all right down there? The cameraman ends up, that was a great block by Wilkes, and you see just a breakneck speed on the other side. We'll take this timeout. Our cameraman helped out Nigel Ribeiro. We'll take this timeout. We'll be right back on GSU TV. You ready?
Cooking up people that look bad, cooking up people that look bad, cooking up.
welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. The Grambling Tigers trail 45-39. Let's go over to Taylor for this sideline report.
All right, just about 5 minutes into the second half of the game, and your Tigers are trailing the Mississippi Valley Devils by about 5 points. We just saw Nigel Bell slide across the floor like he was hiding in home base. Again, the Tigers have got to keep the momentum up and the energy up if they want to win this game tonight. Back to you, Santoria.
All right, thanks a lot, Taylor. And so now Grambling with the basketball. Raymond Brown will inbound, gets it over to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell takes the baseline, spins up, goes up for the shot, no good, and tried to get his own rebound, and it comes down to number 11, and that's Colin Phillips. Ugbe right there. Nice job by Ugbe. And a shot up and good by Tajay Henry. Henry doesn't look that tall on the floor, but he's 6'5". Chase Cormier picked his dribble up. Now to Raymond Brown. Nearly traveled with the basketball. Gets it to Ugbe. Nice job on the baseline by Ugbe. Can't hit the bucket. Gotta hit those buckets. Those are easy buckets. Henry back up for the shot. No good. Ball tipped around. Ugbe with the rebound. Fourteen forty remaining in this ball game. 3 second violation charged to Grambling. Valley up by 8 now. Well, they had it down to about 5, and then the technical foul happened. Raymond Brown hitting the ball, and Ugbe with the rebound. Now to Chase Cormier. Got to get some spacing on the floor here. Get to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell goes in for the shot. Up, go! 3 point play the hard way. Great job by Cormier. Comes down, recognizes Mitchell, and boy, he takes that dribble and just really penetrates. And that's what they need, more dribble drive penetration, drawing the foul. Coming into the lineup now for the Grand for Mississippi Valley will be Baca Vaughn. And coming out of the ball game will be Isaac Williams. 3 point play the hard way, 47-42. Back to a 5 point deficit here. Tigers need a win here to go to 5-4. Start the second half of the season with a very tough trip against Alcorn and Southern coming up. And Wilkes is going to draw the foul. Wilkes with his first personal. And Wilkes is going to be called with a foul, just reaching in. And it had a hand on the back, too. Shot up and good. 49-42. 13-43 remaining in the ballgame. 2-1-2 press set up here by, well, actually, it's just man press for the Delta Devils. Man press, full court. Wilkes gets it to Raymond Brown, goes up, gets the bucket. Well, you can see Coach Walker really into it now, really encouraging the team. That's going to be a foul on Raymond Brown. That's his third personal. And Coach Walker telling Brown just to make sure that he does not get bad positioning. That's all it was, just bad positioning on that foul. Ugbe knocks it into the Valley bench and it goes back to the Grambling Tigers. Valley with the basketball. Nearly losing it was Daryl Riley. 39-44, 12:36 remaining in the ballgame. Shot up and no good. They're going to call a jump ball. Possession goes to Valley. Nice job here inside by Ugbe and Irv Mitchell, and they call a jump ball. And now they want a little bit of a talk about it to see if it was a jump ball or if it was or Grambling had possession. They say it was a jump ball. Now Wilkes comes out of the ball game. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Darryl Riley trying, and now here comes Grambling once again. Irv Mitchell out to Deontay Jones. Jones going in for the shot, good. That was going to be Ugbe with the shot, rather. 49-46, Grambling trailing by just a tray now, with 12:23 remaining in this ball game. Delta Devils with the basketball. Coach Walker telling everybody to get big. Nice steal there, ball on the floor. And is it gonna be a shot clock violation or a jump ball? Either way, it's going to be Grambling's basketball if it's a shot clock violation or a jump ball. Let's look at the inside. As you can see, Romaine going in. He gets the ball taken from him. Shot clock violation. Grambling basketball. At first, they thought that it was going to be a jump ball. Timeout on the floor. 11:58 remaining here in the ball game. 49-46. Grambling trailing by just a tray. We'll be right back.
Remaining in the game, and your Tigers are still trailing behind the Devils by just a few or so points. Your leading scorer right now is Irvin Mitchell, and it looks like he's about to get back into the game to hopefully get these points back up so the Tigers can take the win tonight. Back to you, Santoria.
All right, back here on GSU TV. You're watching it on the YouTube channel. Of course, just go to www.graham.edu and scroll down, and you'll see the YouTube icon. Click there, and you can watch Grambling Basketball Live, Grambling YouTube channel. Deontay Jones now getting it to Brown. Over to Irv Mitchell. Shot up, no good. Ball up in the air still. Ugbe has it. He was hit. No foul call there. And Coach Walker, furious. No call. That's his first person. So Raymond Brown with three. Ugbe with two. Chase with two. Grambling 11 for 15 from the charity stripe. Delta Devils 7 of 12. Thought about the three-pointer. That was number 11, Colin Phillips. Shot up, no good. And a rebound. That's going to be a foul coming up against the Grambling Tigers. Deontay Jones with the foul. Jones, a 6'6 junior from Las Vegas. Free throws coming up here for Marcus Romaine. and Romaine's number. He is coming into the ballgame a 58% free throw shooter, but he's shooting pretty well today. One more opportunity for Romaine as a team. The Delta Devils shoot 60%. They're shooting a little bit below that at 58 as Romaine gets this one to fall. And it's now 51-46, back up to a five-point lead, 10:51 remaining here in this ball game. Delta Devils did not win a non-conference game until they got into conference action. And they got a big one last week against Alabama State. Irv Mitchell for three, no good. And the rebound by Romaine. Delta Devils sent a couple of players to the NBA in the past. Of course, here's a shot up, no good by Jamal Watson. Deontay Jones with the rebound. Here comes Chase Cormier. Gets it out to Raymond Brown. He tried to pass it out to Obey and he threw it off the window. Off the mark. Romaine with a shot good, and the Delta Devils will go to the free throw. 53-46, back out to a seven-point lead. There was a miss, and of course, now Chase Cormier comes out of the ball game. Marcus Romaine at the free throw line. Missing, Deontay Jones with the rebound for Grambling. 53-46 is the score. 9:50 remaining in the ball game. Deontay Jones, nice little stutter step, goes in for the bucket and he's fouled. It's gonna be on Jamal Watson. Delta Devils, of course, had longtime coach Lafayette Stribling at the helm, went to an NC2A tournament regional game out in Richmond, Virginia. Had one player that most notably that went to the NBA was Marcus Mann back in the, even the 90s. Mid to late 90s, Marcus Mann went out there. And then he had another guy who didn't necessarily start the ball game, but really was one of those high-flying guys, George Ivory. And the shot, three-pointer is good. Three-point basket is good, 53-50. Grambling trailing. Here's a steal by Irv Mitchell. Obey with the slam! Timeout, Mississippi Valley. They want to stop the momentum right now. And the Grambling Tigers want to keep that momentum up. 9:19 remaining here in the ball game, and the Grambling Tigers are on top, or are trailing by one, 53-52. And you can see the replay here. Look at this job here. Irv Mitchell to Ugbe with the slam. Great play there, of course, by Irv Mitchell. And now the Tigers only down by 1 point. We'll keep it right here. Just a reminder that coming up on February the 11th, the Grambling State University Tiger basketball teams will be in action against Texas Southern University. Game time for the women is at 3 p.m. and the men's game is at 5:30. Both games live on GSU TV. And then February the 13th, both teams will play against Prairie View A&M University. The women's game tips off at 5:30 and the men's game at 7:30. Exciting Grambling basketball returns here to the Frederick C. Hamdi Assembly Center on February 11th and the 13th. And next week, the Tigers will be on the road for two tough games. First game on Saturday against Southern University. 3 and 5:30 at the F.G. Clark Activity Center. We'll be down there live, and those games will be on radio. Give you more details about that. And then, of course, the Monday tilt at Alcorn. Won't have that on the radio. 53-52, 9:10 left in the ballgame. Romaine trying to get out of trouble, finally does. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Irv Mitchell. Oh, they're going to call a travel. And now the Grambling Tigers get the ball back. Boy, what a great job defensively. You can see right here the Colin Phillips going back to his left, then looking right, and then just took that little bit of a slide. Traveling violation. Coach Andre Payne encouraging his guys. Wilkes gets over to Libero, Brown, now to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell goes up for the shot. Good. And the Grambling Tigers have taken a one-point lead at 54-53. Great job here by Irv Mitchell giving the ball fake and going up and getting the bucket. Now the Delta Devils with the basketball. Romaine gets it over to Riley. Back out to Strother. Romaine. Now to Tajay Henry. Ball is taken away by Grambling, and the clock, shot clock was actually winding down. Nigel Ribeiro thought about the three, pulled back. Will take the baseline. Pops it out to Irv Mitchell. Now to Ribeiro. To Raymond Brown. Brown to Ugbe. Goes up. Gets the bucket. 56-53 now. And now tight defense being played by the Grambling Tigers. Here comes Romaine. Romaine goes up for the shot. No good. Ball tipped around and brought down. Oh, kicked out of bounds, and they say it was off of Grambling. Back to Mississippi Valley. We have a timeout on the floor. Coach Walker applauding the effort of the Grambling Tigers in that last four-minute stretch. 7:23 remaining in the contest. 56-53. Tigers on top. We'll be right back. Welcome back here to the Frederick T. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. The Grambling Tigers on top 56-53. Let's go to Taylor for a sideline report.
Tigers are back in the lead with about 3 points. And that's all thanks to Avery of number 11, who has came in like a fire starter. If Coach Walker wants to keep it up, he's got to keep number 11 in the game. Back to you, Santoria.
56-53 the score, 7:23 left to go in this ball game. And one of the biggest things that this Tiger basketball team can do right now is just to make sure that they keep up that defensive intensity. That's something that they felt like they did not have in that Texas road swing when they played Texas Southern and Prairie View in Houston. And now you can see that defensive pressure starting to get up a little bit more. Three-pointer up, no good, and Grambling getting the rebound. Here's Nadja Ribeiro to Raymond Brown. Three-pointer on the way. No good. Rebound tipped. Drake Brooks tips it out to Raymond Brown. Now to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell gets it out to Nadja Ribeiro. Coach Walker directing traffic. Nadja Ribeiro for three. No good. Ball tipped, and that's going to be a foul charge to Mississippi Valley. And so Coach Walker looking at Nigel Ribeiro telling him, you know, we didn't need a shot from 30 feet. And I believe the foul is going to be on Tajay Henry, third personal, I should say. And Ugbe at the free throw line for the Grambling Tigers. When you look at Ugbe shooting about 61% on the season. Shot up, no good, and Mississippi Valley with the rebound. Ugbe has led this team in rebounding. The last six games, he had 9 against Alcorn, 8 against Texas Southern, 6 against Prairie View, 6 against Jackson, and 11 against Pine Bluff. Missed shot by Mississippi Valley, and it goes back to Grambling. Nigel Rivera with the basketball. Kicks it out to Raymond Brown. Wilkes. Oh, Wilkes was trying to get it over across court to Nigel Rivera on those turnovers. 56-53. Got to cut down on those turnovers. Wilkes comes right back down and he redeems himself. Raymond Brown off of Mississippi Valley and it comes back to Grambling. I'll tell you what, this team can give you a Maalox moment, that's for sure. Ugbe with the basketball, gets it out to Nigel Ribeiro, and now they'll start the offense. Drake Wilkes now gets the basketball. He's one-on-one, baby hook up, and can't get the shooter's roll, but a good shot there by Drake Wilkes. Romaine with the basketball. Now he gets it back out to Colin Phillips. To Riley. Henry. Three-pointer by Henry. No good. They're going to call it Nigel Rivera. And that was with 6 seconds left on the shot clock. And for Rivera, that'll be his second personal. Three shots at the line for Romaine, probably one of their better free throw shooters. Hits the first one, and he can actually tie the ball game up if he hits all three. Second free throw is up and good. Vaca Vaughn comes in the ball game to replace number 24, Isaac Williams. Hits all three, and we have a tie up 56-54. Or 55 now, they say. Irv Mitchell with the basketball. Goes through traffic, gets it to Chase Cormier. 56-55 the score. Ugbe now sets the pick. Cormier to Drake Wilkes. 11 left on the shot clock. Wilkes. Pass out to Raymond Brown. No good. Wilkes gets the shot back up. Goes in for the shot. No good. He'll go for the free throw line. Nice aggressive play there by Wilkes. And a foul coming up on Colin Phillips. And I think that's number 3 for him. That's 4. Well, you go right there. You see, nice job getting the ball out to Raymond Brown. And Drake Wilkes right there. Trying to get that ball in there to try to get the continuation. But he does get a shot at the charity stripe. Wilkes with the free throw up and no good. Tigers at the last media timeout, 12 of 17, 20 of 45 from the field, shooting right around 44%. Second free throw he hits, 57-55 now. Carlton Lowe coming into the ballgame now for Drake Wilkes. Not a starter, but a heck of a contributor. Now Ugbe, being told by the official, you can travel the line, just don't go over it. Irv Mitchell nearly was able to pick that ball off. Here's Romaine with the shot. It's up, it's no good. And a foul coming up. And now Coach Sean Walker kind of telling the official, how can you call that? Timeout Grambling, 4:25. Remaining here in this ball game. Coach Walker coming out talking to Timeout on the floor, and let's see if they're going to take a full timeout. They will take a full timeout, so let's take a timeout here with them. 57-55, the score, 4:25 remaining in the ball game. We'll take a one-minute timeout. 1 minute, we'll be right back. Time Valley did have a 10-point lead. You know, you go back and you look at a couple of their ball games that they've had. There have been some close ones. You look at the game that they had against Jackson State University. That was a little bit of a blowout. But that overtime win against Texas Southern University, 103-89. Then, of course, a bad loss against Prairie View. Close loss, 6 points to Southern University. And then, of course, they beat Alcorn at Alcorn, 84-77, more of a rival game, and then beat Alabama State at Valley, 73-70, but lose to A&M, 79-76. First free throw by Romaine is up and no good. One more at the line. And so now for this Delta Devil team, 3 wins right now in the conference is all that they have. They're 3-5, bottom of the pack. Free throw is up and good. 1 of 2 at the line, 57-56 now, 4:25 left to go in the ball game. Delta Devils need a win desperately to go in 4-5. If they do that, of course, they will catapult above Grambling. Which Grambling, depending on what Jackson does with Arkansas, Pine Bluff, and what Prairie View does tonight, could drop all the way down to right around 7th or 8th. So this win is important here for the Grambling Tigers. Nigel Ribeiro taking the dribble. Back to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell's shot from the elbow. Good! And now Coach Sean Walker telling the official. And so now the Coach Sean Walker is just really upset about the calls here by the officials, and he is all over. The ball boy gave the broom to the official and said, hey, you can get that up. Into the Valley lineup, number 24, and that's going to be Isaac Williams, a 6'4 senior. Powder Springs, Georgia, transfer from Barton Community College. Quite a few community college transfers for this Mississippi Valley team. You got Rashawn Searles, who hasn't seen time tonight, Tajay Henry. And, of course, Michael Matlock, who started the ball game, but we really haven't seen a lot of him. Isaac Williams. Amos Given also. And Marcus Romaine. Valley with the basketball. 3:43 left to go in this ball game. They call that foul on Irv Mitchell. And Irv Mitchell didn't agree with the call. And let's see what they call here. A little bit of hand checking. And really and truthfully, Marcus Romaine actually had Irv Mitchell's arm. And they call the foul on Irv. 59-56 to score. 3:37 remaining in the contest. First free throw by Romaine is up and good. I want to go back to that play if we could, just to kind of show what Irv Mitchell was talking about. Irv Mitchell actually had, well, his arm was actually being held by Marcus Romaine. Second free throw up, no good, 59-57 to score. And here's the play right here. Irv Mitchell coming around, and you can see a little pushing and shoving, but here's the hook there. He's got Irv Mitchell's arm. Irv Mitchell doesn't have him. Ugbe with the basketball. Here's Chase Cormier. Cormier now looking, getting it to Nigel Rivero. Mitchell going in, trying to get the shot. It's up, no good. It's going to be Grambling basketball after the miss. Looks like Mitchell was hammered. And now Coach Sean Walker just looking at the official like, what? And they say that it was not a foul. ...59-57. Tigers need a stop here to preserve that lead. 3 minutes remaining in the ball game. Three-pointer on the way. Good stroke by Isaac Williams. Williams kind of left open. He's one of those three-point threats for the Delta Devils. And it's now 60-59. Delta Devils now have a one-point lead. 2:42 left to go in this ball game. Irv Mitchell inside to Ugbe. Now to Chase Cormier. He'll take a three. Good! Second timeout charge to the Grambling Tigers. 2:33 left to go in this ball game. And more Chase Cormier getting it to Irv Mitchell, and then Mitchell inside to Ugbe. Nice job popping it back out, and Chase Cormier with the shot going around the world and in the net. 62-60 now the score with 2:33 left to go in the ball game. We're going to get a report here in just a second from Taylor. 2:33 in the ball game, 62-60 the score. Coach Sean Walker telling all of his guys, don't foul. Carlton Lowe being one of them. If I'm not mistaken, Carlton Lowe has a couple here. We're going to go over so that for the sideline reports to Taylor Stewart.
Few minutes left in the game, and your Tigers have jumped in the lead 62-60. Just had a great shot by Chase Cormier. You know, all the Tigers have to do is keep it up just a few minutes longer, and they will take the win today and move up in the ranks in the SWAC tournament. Thank you. Back to Santoria.
All right, Chase Cormier coming into the ball game. Carlton Lowe coming out. Raymond Brown now swapping with Avril Ugbe, putting him on Taj Henry. A little bit better of a matchup there as far as size. And now coming into the ball game, Steve Wilkes takes out Irv Mitchell for a quick breather. Irv Mitchell will be back here in just a second. They're telling everybody to back up. Three-pointer on the way, no good by Isaac, and here comes Grambling. Nigel Rivera going in for the shot, no good. Ugbe with the rebound, he goes back in for the shot, it's no good. Ball tipped around, Ugbe has it. He goes back in, trying for the shot, no good, and draws a foul. Boy, talk about teams going to the boards. Ugbe finally got fouled as he brought the ball back down. He looks like he was fouled by Taj Henry. First free throw by Ugbe, no good, and those are the ones that you need. Nigel Rivera over there talking to assistant coach Kyle Jones. About to have a substitution if this free throw is good. No good, and they needed those two. That would have taken them to a four-point lead. And they don't call, oh, they call a foul late. You gotta be kidding. Wow, talk about a late call on the foul. Here comes Ugbe. And then of course driving is Daryl Riley. No call here, ball goes around. They finally call this late. Couple of free throws coming up. Ugbe with three. First free throw up and no good. Ball doesn't lie. Here comes Ugbe down the floor. As you can see here, I can't dispute that there was a foul, because I think that there was. I think it was just really late in calling it. I can't dispute the foul, because it could have went either way. Free throw is up. Good. 62-61 coming into the ball game now will be Jamal Watson. He's had limited time tonight, mainly for the defensive side of the ball. Nigel Ribeiro, Drake Wilkes, Avril Ugbe, Raymond Brown, and Chase Cormier in the ballgame now for the Grambling Tigers. Cormier with the basketball, looking, gets it to Ugbe. Now to Steve, it's Drake Wilkes. Inside to Ugbe. Ugbe, the drive, the shot, goes up, draws a foul. And I believe that foul is going to be charged to Jamal Watson. Let's look at the replay here, see if that's going to be Tajay Henry, or is it going to be Watson? I think it's going to be Watson with that foul. That's his second personal. Free throw no good. Boy, those are big. Three free throws in the last minute that are huge. Need this one to at least have a two-point advantage. And the ball game for the Grambling Tigers will be number 22, Carlton Lowe. Oh, Ugbe missed both of them. Four in a row that he's missed. 62-61. Shot up, no good. Put back is good by number 13, and that's Jabari Alex. And if I'm not mistaken, for Alex, that's his first bucket of the ball game. They awarded the wrong points. They gave it to Marcus Romaine, but it actually was Jabari Alex. 63-62, Grambling trailing by one. Raymond Brown goes up for the shot, no good, and Valley with the basketball. They call a blocking foul. And you can tell Ribeiro is frustrated. You look at the replay. Ball was tipped. Ribeiro comes over. I guess they said the slide over didn't really have positioning. Got the wrong guy at the free throw line tonight, because he has been hot at the charity stripe. 63-62. First free throw up and no good. 109 remaining. Substitutions in now for the Grambling Tigers. Irv Mitchell, Chase Cormier for Mississippi Valley. You got Amos Given, that's for defense, as well as Colin Phillips for ball handling. Mississippi Valley. 64-62. Nigel Ribeiro now coming back into the ball game. They brought him down. Could tell that he was a little frustrated. He wants to make sure that his head stays in the ball game. Nigel Ribeiro with the basketball. Gets it across the half court line. Not a Chase Cormier. No mistakes. Need a bucket here. 56 seconds remaining. 64-62. Raymond Brown goes in for the bucket. Offensive foul charge to Raymond Brown. There's no way. And for Raymond Brown, that's four. Wow. Timeout, Mississippi Valley, 64-62. They call that offensive foul on Raymond Brown. That's a tough call. Timeout on the floor. We'll take a timeout as well with 51 seconds remaining. It's 64-62. Tigers need a stop in the bucket. We'll be right back. out the three-pointer. 42 seconds left. Kaiser Rivera playing up. No need to foul. Only 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Grambling with the basketball. Irv Mitchell with the steal. Mitchell going in with the shot. Good! Tie ball game. 19 seconds remaining. And we have another timeout on the floor, Mississippi Valley. Boy, this is going to be a barn burner. Irv Mitchell with the steal and the bucket. Two on one, split the defender. Great camel work there. And Irv Mitchell did a great job of splitting the defender. And Coach Sean Walker on the official right now about some of the controversial calls late here in the ball game. Really wants an explanation here. And I can't say I really blame him. You know, late in the ball game, sometimes you just want a little bit of an explanation. You're trying to buy a break, and sometimes the breaks don't necessarily go your way. 64-64, 19.6 seconds left. And the main thing here for the Grambling Tigers to remember is that they're going to go over, and they're watching a replay screen now. So if you see the officials on the opposite side of the floor, they are actually getting a replay and looking at how much time is left after the made shot by Irv Mitchell. Mitchell, of course, gets the ball and, of course, gets the bucket. And they want to see how much time is remaining after the made bucket. That's what the officials are doing right now, is looking at that replay. Once again, here is the steal, but they're looking to see how much time is left. So there's going to be a little bit more time left. There's got to be about 21 seconds or so left in the ball game. Nice job by the camera guys, because you could see how much time was left on the big clock. 21.4. 21.3 is what they're going to call it. Carlton Lowe, Raymond Brown, Nigel Ribeiro, Irv Mitchell, and Avril Ugbe in for Grambling. Marcus Romaine, that's the man they want with the ball for the Delta Devils. 15 seconds remaining here in the ball game. Delta Devils trying to play for one shot. 9 seconds remaining. Here is Marcus Romaine. He's the wrong one with the basketball, one-on-one. Takes a drive, takes a step, shot up, no good. We're going to overtime. We are going to overtime. Extra session here at the Hobby Assembly Center, tied at 64. And now the Grambling Tigers have life again, 0-0. The shot by Romaine was up and good. Now here's a question. They're going to look at that tip. They're going to look at that tip to see if the tip was in before the light was on. And I don't think it was. Let's look at that again. Nope, the clock had expired. Clock had expired before the tip. And so we're going into overtime. Tied at 64. We'll be right back. Yeah, the light was on. Tied at 64. Some important numbers to know about here. The Grambling Tigers have Raymond Brown in foul trouble with 4. Avril Ugba with 3. for the Delta Devils. They've got two players with four, including Tajay Henry and Colin Phillips, two guys who can handle the ball and can hurt you. Tajay Henry jumping at center with Averill Ugbe to start the extra session. Ball is tipped and Grambling will control to start the overtime session. Into a little late basketball here in Northern Louisiana. The Tigers trying to win one here. This will be the first overtime game for the Tigers this season. Second in a week for Mississippi Valley. Ugbe gets fouled. And I think that foul may be charged to Daryl Riley. Nope, it's going to be charged to Marcus Romaine, second. Ugbe is at the free throw line, and for Ugbe, he has not shot well at the charity stripe. Needs these free throws desperately. First one is good. Coach Sean Walker applauding the effort. Now coming into the ball game, Isaac Williams. Second free throw at the charity stripe. Good. Two for two for Ugbe. 66-64. Both teams over the limit in fouls. Two shots all the way through. 4:32 remaining here in the overtime session. Daryl Riley controlling. Bounce pass into Marcus Romaine. Romaine blocking foul charge to Nigel Ribeiro. Boy, that is really ticky-tack. Nigel Ribeiro got clubbed with an elbow. How are they calling that an offensive foul? Coach Sean Walker also in amazement that that's not an offensive foul. First free throw up and good, 66-65. Coming back into the ball game, Kylan Phillips. Amazing. Second free throw up, good. 66 all again, 4:25. Little gift from the official right there. Chase Cormier coming across the half court line. Cormier looking inside, gets it to Raymond Brown. Brown driving with the shot up. Good. Raymond Brown giving Grambling 68-66 lead. Now Daryl Riley, who's played a good majority of the game out on the floor. Michael Matlock, who started, as well as Jamal Watson, really not getting the time today. Marcus Romaine for three. No good. Ball tipped up in the air. Oh, Chase Cormier, they couldn't grab it. Romaine got the shot blocked. And the Grambling Tigers playing ferocious defense inside. Romaine, three-pointer, no good. Rebound by Ugbe to Nigel Ribeiro. Ribeiro coming down the sideline. Now looking, had the guy open, and it looks like it's going to be a foul charge to Mississippi Valley. That foul is going to be charged to Daryl Riley's second personal, and now Raymond Brown at the line to shoot two. Brown needs these free throws here, a 65% free throw shooter. First one's good. Three-point lead now, 3:05 remaining in the ball game. Now coming into the contest, it's 24, Isaac Williams, who has hurt Grambling a little bit today. He has had a few three-pointers. Second free throw, good. Coach Payne trying to direct the offense. It's a motion offense here for the Delta Devils. Inside pass up, good. Count the bucket. Boy, is that a garbage bucket. That foul is going to be on Irv Mitchell. And for Irv Mitchell, that's three. 70-68. Grambling had that four-point lead, but boy, that's a big bucket there by Jabari Alex. Well, I believe has 2 points. Probably had four on the night. And he gets the bucket. Barry Alex has only shot about six free throws all season, including that one. And that couldn't come at a bigger time. 70-69, 2:39 remaining. Grambling on top. Chase Cormier with the ball. Marcus Romaine on the ball. Now to Nigel Ribeiro, inside to Ugbe. Ugbe goes in, gets the bucket. And now they're picking up everybody, full court man. Marcus Romaine now with the basketball. And Irv Mitchell is furious along with Coach Walker. How can they call a foul on Mitchell? I'm just amazed. He hooked him. Oh, what a flop. You got to be kidding me. You have got to be kidding me. The officials have been baited. There's no way you could have called that. Go back to the replay if you could. That is high school elementary 101. He's going through there and just flops right there. Mitchell never touched the guy. Never touched him. 72-70. That was a clear travel. Two for two at the line. 2:18 remaining, and another gift from the official. Elementary officiating. Irv Mitchell, no call there. Gets out to Nigel Ribeiro for three. No good. And Valley with the basketball, 1:58 remaining. Boy, those were some tough calls there against Grambling. Ball goes out of bounds to Larry Gibson, the PA announcer. We'll go back to Valley with 12 seconds left on the shot clock. Boy, those were some tough calls against the Tigers. When they go back and look at that film, the officials will definitely see Irv Mitchell never touched Romaine. It was a clear flop. Steal by Grambling. 1.5 remaining, 72-71. Grambling needs a bucket here. You got to forget about the no calls and the somewhat calls. You got to go ahead and play basketball here, and that's what Coach Walker is telling them. First overtime game here for the Grambling Tigers. Second in a week here for Mississippi Valley. Last one they had. Here's Brown in for the bucket, 74-71. Timeout Grambling. They didn't want Valley to get anything set up. So a timeout on the floor. Brown goes in and gets the bucket. But I want to go back to that. I don't know if we can or not. Go back to that replay on that foul that was called against Irv Mitchell. And the reason I'm going back to this is because I want you to see why everybody was really upset about that. Irv Mitchell did not touch Marcus Romaine. Now you can see right here where Taj Henry with the basketball, and it was knocked out. Can't go back to it, but anyway, the Marcus Romaine never was touched when he actually was falling into action. Never touched. Here's Marcus Romaine here. Never touched by Irv Mitchell. That's why we said somebody was not in position and officiating. And I can say that because I have been an official. And one of the things that you look at is when you've got close calls like that, you have to make sure that they were even touched. And in that instance, Irv Mitchell did not touch Marcus Romaine. He goes through here. Nobody ever touched him. So So some good acting, got two free throws for Mississippi Valley. But nonetheless, Coach Walker did tell the guys during the timeout, you can't worry about that. You've got to keep playing. You got to play defense and put the game in your hands. Defense! 21 left on the shot clock. 54 seconds left in overtime. Switch here. 3-point. Almost a travel by Isaac Williams. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Up, no good. Rebound by Colin Phillips. Phillips will take a three. It's up, good. Colin Phillips with a huge three-pointer for Mississippi Valley. That was just impressive. It's intense. And Coach Sean Walker is just telling everybody, you got to make sure you play in defense. Drake Rooks now will go into the ball game for the Grambling Tigers. Coach Walker is just kind of getting his guys together to make sure you tell them you got to play defense. Look at that shot. First shot here was by Isaac Williams. It was no good, but a great job. A long rebound out to Connor Phillips. And, boy, he stepped outside. Nobody was out there really on him until at the last minute when Raymond Brown was out there. By that time, he hit the shot, tied it at 74. Now, Grambling will get the basketball. As you can see, Isaac Williams with the shot off the iron, and that one went long. And this is where you got to get out there. And Raymond Brown got out there too late. By then, Colin Phillips had already set up and crushed it. 38 seconds remaining in the overtime session. There's an 8-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. And so now when the Grambling Tigers get the basketball, they'll be defended full court. They'll get a chance to run the baseline in order to try to get the ball in. But I guarantee you, Grant, that Mississippi Valley is either going to play press or full court man, and they're going to make a few defensive changes in here in order to make sure that they have the right personnel. Coming in now for the Grambling Tigers, they've got Irv Mitchell, Drake Wilkes, Raymond Brown, Avril Ugbe, and Chase Cormier. And coming in now for the Delta Devils, Jabari Alex, Tajay Henry, Marcus Romain, Lorenzo Hunt, and on the ball, Colin Phillips, who just had the big three-pointer. 35 seconds left, full court man set up. Phillips will defend Cormier. He's going out for the steal. Ugbe with the basketball. Out of Drake Wilkes to Chase Cormier. 14 on the shot clock. Cormier to Raymond Brown. 10 seconds. Inside to Irv Mitchell. Mitchell gets inside the paint. Goes up for the shot. Good! 14 seconds left. Timeout on the floor. And they're going to go back to the clock to see how much time was left, I believe. They're telling all the players to get back on the floor. See how much time was left when Irv Mitchell hit that shot, 76-74. 15 seconds, it looks like. They're going to go to the replay screen here. Looks like 15 seconds remain. Inside to Irv Mitchell. Don't know if you can see it from that angle. You can see it from the other one. Mitchell gets the bucket. You can see the time from the other angle, and it looks like it's going to be about 15 seconds left. The clock stops when the ball goes through. And there you see the clock coming into the frame. It goes through at 15.1. Looks like right around 15 or 15.1. So about another half a second or so going back on the clock. Coach Sean Walker applauding his guy. They're telling all of his guys, play good defense and rebound. Here's a shot up, and there's a good shot right there through the hoop. About 15 seconds, and that's what the officials are looking at. They're looking at the same replay as we are. And so they're going to keep it at 14-6. And a timeout now by Mississippi Valley. So 14.6 remaining. Carlton Lowe now in the ballgame. 30-second timeout taken by the Mississippi Valley State Delta Devils. Don't forget, coming up on February the 11th, the Grambling State University basketball teams will welcome Texas Southern. That's their next home game. Women's game at 3 p.m. and the men's game at 5:30. Then on February the 13th, Prairie View A&M will come to town. Women's game at 5:30, men's at 7:30. And of course, you can watch all the action live on GSU TV. Official comes over and tells everybody that it's first home. Coach is really telling his guys, don't foul and rebound. Want everybody to get their hands up. Setting up the defense. And it looks like it's going to be somewhat of a one, kind of a loose press setup here. 12 seconds remaining. Here's Marcus Romaine. Turnover. Ball is got by Ogbe. Up to Chase Cormier. Cormier keeps the ball. 4 seconds remaining. Cormier fouled with 2 seconds left. Cormier did a fantastic job of not forcing a shot and missing. Cormier was at full speed, and instead of him trying to force a shot up, he came around, kept the ball, and is fouled. 76-74, still time left. So Cormier needs to get these two free throws. And coming out of the ball game, Isaac Williams. Still got a couple of free throws here. Seeing crazy things happen. So it's so important for them to get two free throws here. Two free throws and just get away and let them shoot. Cormier with a shot, no good. Now this is interesting, because they can throw the ball the length of the floor. That's why you needed that first free throw. Valley out of timeouts, Grambling with one. Free throw good by Cormier. Shot up, no good. And the Grambling Tigers win the basketball game. The final score is 77-74. Tigers win and sweep Mississippi Valley. All right, we're going to see if we can't get Sean Walker, head coach of the Grambling Tigers, here in just a couple of minutes. But first of all, we'll take this timeout. We'll take this time out. You're listening and watching Grambling State University basketball. We'll be right back. We're going to do Sean Walker here. Thank you.
and keep running.
Yeah.
Oh.
Turn yours on.
So we was done.
Hey, turn it back on, bro.
What's it for?
Song still, okay, cool.
You still focused though?
Hey, put mine on, cause that shit ain't
real. Damn, I unplugged both of my cables.
Get that purple cable.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hamdi Assembly Center, where the Grambling State University Tigers victorious 77-74 in overtime, joined by the head coach of the Grambling Tigers, Sean Walker. You really believe in these Maalocs moments, don't you?
We definitely played the worst game tonight that we've played in a long time. Mississippi Valley, obviously, is a credit for that. They muddied the game up, and we're fortunate to win, but I'm happy. Extremely happy. I mean, we've got our 10th win of the season. I believe before the year, that was one of our goals. I don't think Grambling has had a 10-win season in a long time, which is a testament to our players. They fought tonight. Although we didn't play well and we turned the ball over, we missed free throws, but the character of this team and our intestinal fortitude carried us over and got us a win tonight.
Coach, it's something that you really can be proud of the players about, because you talked about how Mississippi Valley muddied the game up a little bit, and then you also saw some calls in there that we didn't quite agree with, but at the same time, the Tigers really fought through all of that, and sometimes you need that ugly win.
Well, we just need to win. You know, last year we lost, I believe, 7 or 8 conference games by 1 or 2 points. We lost to Mississippi Valley here by 1, I believe. So now the tides are turning a little bit, and we're learning how to win some of those close games. We win tonight in regulation if we just make free throws.
Mm-hmm.
We missed enough layups tonight to have had a comfortable lead. But Marcus Romain is a really good player. They've got a really good team. That team is, I guess they're 3-20 now, but they're much better than 3-20, and not a fun team to play against. So I was proud of my guys.
You look at the standings now, of course, and this is where we talk about ending the first half of the season on an upswing. 5-4 after the first half of the season, going into next week's games against Alcorn and Southern, which Alcorn had a really big win on Saturday night against Southern University. That's a much better team, and they had 4 players out against Southern on Saturday.
Alcorn's really good. We were fortunate enough to beat them here. They're probably one of the most talented teams. They're big and strong and talented. Southern handed us an awful loss here, the only conference loss that we've had at home. Got really good players. This league is balanced, though. I mean, we're 5-4. I feel like we very well could have, you know, been 0-9, and I also feel like we could have been 9-0. And so that's a testament to the league this year. Texas Southern's gotten through the league and has only had 1 loss, and they lost to Mississippi Valley. So this league is tough, and you know, we're proud to be where we are.
Coach, appreciate your time. Enjoy the win. Short win, though, because you got a trip to Baton Rouge and Lorman coming up.
Well, we'll worry about that on Wednesday. We'll take tomorrow off, come back Wednesday, have 3 days to get ready for them, and hopefully we can play well.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Coach Sean Walker joining us here on the post-game show. It's been great. A great night of basketball, both the men and the women. both get a win tonight. The women, of course, win early, and then, of course, the men late, which means that both teams swept Arkansas Pine Bluff and Mississippi Valley. Now, it really makes things interesting on the men's side because we have to wait and see what happens with Prairie View, also with Jackson State and Arkansas Pine Bluff, because that win could mean a little fluctuation there. But Grambling right now can't go any lower than fifth place, and we'll see what happens by the end of the night. I want to thank the entire GSU television crew for an outstanding job here this evening. And, of course, we will see you coming up on February the 11th when the Grambling Tigers will host the Texas Southern University Tigers. For the entire broadcast crew, Leon Thomas, we want to see you next time right here on GSU TV. Always remember, one nation, one people. Peace.